Now, before you can get into talking about moments in 3D, it's really important to talk about cross products. And hopefully this will be a review from what you've seen in a physics class, hopefully. If I define a cross product, A cross B equals C, what I'm going to do is I can calculate the cross product using a matrix determinant. And if that doesn't make any sense at all, then that's okay, but yeah, you still need to learn it. So there we go. Let's pretend that I have A, B, and C components there. Do I want to do that? I might as well. I'll do it again later with more complicated looking components, but right now I don't want the complicated looking components to get in the way of actually learning it. Okay, so if you remember how to compute a determinant, the determinant of so A cross B is basically going to be the determinant of IJK and then ABC and then DEF. So maybe you remember that if I'm finding a determinant, first I take this guy and then I multiply him times this minus that. So it's going to be I hat times BF minus CE. Then for a 3D matrix for determinants, we switch the sign. So the first one's positive, the second one's negative. The next one is going to be J hat times AF minus CD. J hat times AF minus CD. And then the last part, again, is positive because we're switching the signs. So it's K hat times AE minus BD. And I wish I had a prettier way to do it. Textbooks have very fancy ways of doing it. So you can check that out and stuff. Yeah, you get what you pay for. Sorry. So there we go. That's a cross product. And doesn't that just make so much sense? Okay. So the reason that this is important when you're dealing with moments is that what a cross product actually does is it pulls all the things that are perpendicular to it. So if you look at this, what you can see is that in the I hat guy, the I hat component only has J, so this is a J, and this is a K, and this is a K, and this is a J. In the J hat component, it only has I's and K's, so this is an I and this is a K. This is a K and this is an I. And the K hat component only has I's and J's, so I, J, J, I. Okay, so this is why we need to know cross products, is because what that does is it helps us find all the perpendicular contributions to finding a moment. So we'll do that in a bit, but what we want to look at now is just some general rules about cross products. Maybe you remember, if you've seen this before, that the magnitude of a cross product is A, the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the sign between them. So I've got a vector, I've got a vector A, vector B, and they are apart, that the magnitude of A cross B, so again, this is magnitude, is AB sine theta. Okay? And this only, again, only works in three dimensions. And luckily in statics, we don't do four-dimensional problems, which is excellent. Got it? And again, this is intended to be mostly review. I'm not trying to teach you cross products the way a mathematician would. By the time you get to statics, you hopefully are taking Cal 3 or Cal 2 and are seeing this at the same time. So here are some properties of cross products that are useful to know. The first one is that A cross B is not equal to B cross A. So it's not equal to B cross A, but it's actually equal to negative B cross A. And you can figure this out. So A cross B, basically what you're doing is this is the right-hand rule again. You want to stick your fingers in the direction of A. So let's look at this example. I'll just draw it again. So if I had A cross B, if I stick my fingers in the direction of A, and then I curl them down toward B, fingers in the direction of A, curl them down toward B, my thumb's going to be pointing into the page, right? So I'm going to do this thumb pointing in. Now for B cross A, I'm writing it over there for a special reason. Now B cross A, if I stick my palm here, stick my fingers in this direction and curl them toward A, my thumb is pointing up. Okay, so my thumb is pointing up or out of the page. So basically you're going to get the same answer, but this one's going to be pointing out, and this one's going to be pointing out, and this one's going to be pointing in. So that's why I would say that A cross B isn't exactly B cross A, but it's negative B cross A. So that's where it comes from. So this is a good formula to have in your arsenal. A couple of others I'm really not going to get into, but they might come up. If you're doing some kind of scalar and you're multiplying it times A cross B, you can either choose to apply it to one, apply it to the other one, or do the cross product first and then multiply it by alpha, and you're going to get the same answer. So that's another one that's good to have. And then finally, A cross B plus C is the same thing as A cross B plus A cross C. So you can kind of distribute it if that makes sense to you to think about it that way. Okay? Now, the last thing that you want to make sure that you're really, really clear on cross products is what happens when you cross the I-hat, J-hat, and K-hat vectors. So draw yourself a nice, pretty thing with Y, X, and Z, and I'm going to color all over this. Basically, we're going to fill out a table. This is maybe a little too big for what I'm trying to do. It would be so hard to have to redraw that. We're basically going to fill this out. I want to make sure y'all can get I-hat cross I-hat, I-hat cross J-hat, I-hat cross K-hat, and then similarly to get J cross I, J cross J, J cross K, and then K cross I, no, you're too far over. K cross I, K cross J, and K cross K. Okay? So I want to go ahead and look at, I'm going to skip this first one for a second, but I'm going to go ahead and go on to I cross J. So put your palm here, go in the I direction, and curl your fingers toward J. Your thumb should be pointing up. And remember that up is the K hat direction. So fingers in I, fingers toward I, curl toward J, and your thumb's pointing up. Okay, now for the second one, we want to stick our fingers in the I-hat direction, curl them toward K, and your thumb should be pointing to the left. Right? I, up, thumb pointing to the left, and that's the negative J-hat direction. Okay? Now I'm going to go to the next one. So see if you can do these on your own. See if you can make them make sense. This is also a great way to make sure that you understand the right-hand rule. So I'm going to stick my fingers in the J direction, curl them toward I, and my thumb is pointing down. Okay, so thumb pointing down, so that's negative K hat. All right, I'm going to skip the next one, but I'm going to go to J cross K. So fingers in the J direction, curl them up toward K, and your thumb should be pointing, curl up toward K, should be pointing in the positive I direction. Now we can actually do a dummy check right here. See that this one and this one are almost the same. We know that I cross J is K, so it only makes sense that J cross I is negative K based on one of our cross product properties, that if you reverse the order of the cross product, you're just going to get the same thing but in the opposite direction. And that's exactly what we see here. So that's good to know. It's good to know we aren't crazy. No! What did you do? Go back. Okay. Next thing. Look at this guy. So fingers in the K direction, curl them toward I. Your thumb should be pointing in the positive J direction. And again, we see that this corresponds to that. They're in a different order, and they're pointing in different directions, but they have the same magnitude. All right, and now we're going to do K. Stick our fingers in the K direction, curl toward J, and your thumb is going to be pointing backwards. So your thumb is going to be pointing in the negative I-hat direction. And again, we see that this is the opposite of that, which is, again, excellent. Now we have three more holes in our table. And to explain this, it might be a little bit easier to go back to a previous example where we had kind of a wrench going around. We said, well, what happens if I pull on the wrench? If my position vector and my force vector are in the same direction, that thing doesn't rotate, right? Because you're pulling on it. It's not going to rotate. There's no moment arm. There's no perpendicular distance. So we can come in here and we can say that that's in blue, so it's fancy. That I cross I is 0, J cross J is likewise 0, and K cross K is 0. So if you're crossing things in the same direction, you're not actually creating any kind of a moment.